and welcome to the Fanish Inquisition at WesterCon 70 in Tempe, Arizona.
This is a fine place to be.
The purpose of this event is to give people an opportunity to question bidders for future WesterCons and the seated future WesterCon. We'll have individual sessions for each. And first up is the constitutionally guaranteed presentation for bidders for WesterCon 72. That's the 2019 WesterCon. There is one bidder on the ballot. It is Utah. And I'd like to invite the representative. That's Ben, right?
Yes, sir.
Again, could be Ben Hatcher, come up here. And you have up to 15 minutes of presentation and Q&A. So do want to remind everyone these presentations are being recorded. The presentations will be posted to YouTube as soon as it is practical for us to do so. So, and we will have a break in between each presentation. Ben, come on.
Morning, everybody. Thank you for coming. I appreciate your time greatly. My name is Ben Hatcher. I'm the bid chair for Utah for 2019, bidding for WesterCon 72. Our intent is to hold it in Layton, Utah. And honestly, I would love to hear your questions.
So we'll take this only as Q&A. You don't have any other statement to make on this?
No, sir. Not at this time.
All right. Does anyone have any questions of WesterCon, of the bid for Utah? Linda?
Is this the same group that bidded 4 years ago?
No, ma'am. We have two of the same members from WesterCon 67, Mr. Dave Doring and Charles here, who's in our audience. My wife is also was a part of WesterCon 67, but it is not the same group that ran.
Okay.
Any other questions for the bid? In the back.
Yes,
ma'am. Judith Bemis. I know that voting gets you a supporting membership. Does adding a pre-support at your bid table give you an attending, or will everybody be concerned?
Yes, ma'am, it does.
All right, so supporting members who vote get an automatic attending membership.
As long as you pre-support and vote, you receive a full attending upgrade to attending membership. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
And you had a question.
In 2014, WesterCon was run co-gently, essentially, with Conduit. Is that true this time?
Is this, will it be combined with Conduit, or is it just a standalone WesterCon? We'll get to the NASDAQ in a moment.
This is a standalone.
So let's go ahead and ask the other question implicit in this. You appear to be also bidding for the presumed 2019 NASDAQ, bearing in mind that technically no NASDAQ is required until a non-North American site wins. However, the only bidder for the 2019 WorldCon is outside North America. So you want to talk about your NASDAQ bid as well?
Yes, sir. In 2018, our intention is to go to San Jose, California to stand in and bid for the NASDAQ 2019.
And therefore, anybody who joins the WesterCon in intervening year, assuming you win your NASDAQ bid, they'll also be members of NASDAQ with no additional charge, correct?
There's a small markup that we added in for the NASDAQ to cover voting fees and everything else.
You'll be able to attend the convention, but
yes, sir.
That's what I'm saying. Okay, so you're intending, if you want voting rights, there's one potential voting right in the NASDAQ. You'd have to a slight upgrade to your membership if you were only a WesterCon member.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So, which begs the question, actually, if you become a NASDAQ member, do you then have to also pay any additional fee to become a WesterCon member?
As I understand it, I don't believe the reverse is true.
Okay.
I can double check. Let me get your name and number, and as soon as I get that information, I will get it to you.
Assuming you win your WesterCon bid, and if a NASDAQ is required, this is the sort of thing you'll probably want to put in your FAQs for your WesterCon bid.
Yeah.
And then my other question was, you said Layton, Utah?
Yes, ma'am.
And how close is the nearest airport, and is there public transportation?
The airport, I believe, is by memory serving, please. Forgive me if I'm incorrect or inaccurate. I believe that's about like a 30 minute drive down to the airport by the interstate. There is public transportation. The UTA Front Runner will run from the airport area up to the Clearfield area, which is right nearby the event center.
That's the rail transit is the front runner, so. Does the hotel provide transportation to the, to and from the airport?
That's not set in stone yet, but I believe that they are interested in doing so, and I know that the city is willing, has a free shuttle service that will cover that as well.
Yes.
So at what level do you need to pre-support to have your pre-support plus your vote equal an attending membership?
That would be the $25 minimum.
So any level is, I think, the answer.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, any level. And as I understand it then, I don't see any more hands. Okay, oh yes, go on.
Dates, would it, because I know ours, the 4th of July is on a Wednesday, so 4th of July is, I'm assuming, on a Thursday?
I believe so, it would be the 4th through the 7th of July.
Okay, so Thursday through Sunday.
4th, 5th, 6th, and 7th.
Awesome, thank you.
Linda?
Are your hotel rates set yet?
We have tentative letters of intention that we have not signed a full contract yet, but right now the tentative block is for $129 per block number.
Yes, ma'am.
Whatever hotels you use, please inform them that some of us have fragrance allergies.
Yes, ma'am.
And please do not scent the carpets the way the Marriott does. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. We've already been in talk because, not only because of my wife and my own daughter both being handicapped, we have covered the ADA issues as far as everything that we can come up with. Both the event center and the adjoining hotel and the surrounding hotels are more than willing to work with us on all ADA issues.
Great, thank you.
One question that I was asked to ask of you, the last WesterCon down there, which was downtown, was across from an event known as FantasyCon. Has anything happened to that event at this point? Are they dead, or are they still alive, or anything?
Last I heard, it was defunct.
Yes?
I checked. They did renew their business license for this year. As far as I know, they haven't renewed their registered service mark.
So there doesn't seem to be any prospect of another FantasyCon going on the same weekend, or any other time around it. That was the question I was asked to ask.
It only ran the one time.
Yeah, it only ran the one time. Yes. Okay. Yes.
My final question is, what's the weather like?
Okay.
Weather in the area over that 4th of July weekend.
Okay, I cannot predict what it's going to be in 2019, but...
No, just generally speaking, is it
generally
Phoenix?
Speaking, on our website, we have a full listing of all the weather conditions, the variances, temperature, humidity, elevation effect, the whole, as much as we can come up with on the website. I cannot actually quote numbers.
I believe the summary is... probably hot, but nowhere near as hot as we are here. Is that a fair, generally speaking, view is what you'd expect?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
And that, I believe, is the end. We have no more questions.
They do have some lovely charts on their website.
Yes, so go ahead. Now, if you have more questions about their bid, Utah has a table down in the Fan Tables area. Today is the final day of site selection voting for the 2019 convention. Voting will be open at the site selection table, which will open shortly after this program item is over. It'll be open until 6 o'clock tonight in accordance with the WesterCon bylaws, and that will be the end of it. The voting will be done, and the results are not secret. The site selection administrator will begin to circulate the results soon afterwards. Should there be any unusual circumstance, that will be spread even faster. What might be called the nominal official announcement of results will be at the WesterCon business meeting, which will be in this room tomorrow at noon, I believe, but it might be 12:30. I've lost track of which time it is. It's noon or 12:30, check the schedule. But again, your last chance to vote is today. And I believe that's the end for the questions for WesterCon 72.